I would like to add my thanks for everyone for coming this evening. You know, I've known Vince for basically since the Olympics in 2000, when I was around him during the workouts leading up to the Olympic Games. And I have always respected him. I've always respected his game. I've always respected the way he conducted himself. And I feel very fortunate that we were able to get a player of his ilk here without having to give up, you know, either Jason or Richard. And as Bruce alluded to, at the 1, 2, and 3 positions, when you take them collectively, I think we're going to be about as good as anybody in the league. And we're looking forward to winning a lot more games. We're looking forward to a lot of excitement, both here in Continental Arena and also all around the NBA. Because in Vince Carter, we truly have one of the great talents and one of the great players in the NBA today. And I'm looking forward to his going out on the court. You know, he wants to play tonight, by the way, but we're not going to let him play tonight. We think it's prudent that he take a few more days off to make sure that his heel is entirely ready before we go out on the court, because we expect him to be here for a long time. And all of us, as I said, are just looking forward to some great basketball and to some great days here in the Continental Arena. Without further ado, Vince Carter.
Thank you. First of all, I don't really have much to say. I'm just definitely excited about the opportunity. It's a new chapter in my life for my basketball game, and I'm just coming just to add another component and just another element to what's already happened in this organization. You know, we all know what Richard Jefferson's doing right now, what Jason Kidd has done and is doing right now, along with the rest of the guys. And I'm just going to step in and knock down open shots and get a couple of dunks here and there, and we'll see what happens from there. But I'm more than thrilled to be here, and thank you for the opportunity, both of you guys, and I won't let you down, I promise. Thank you, guys.
Okay, we will take questions from the audience. Please remember there'll be limited availability afterwards, so I ask you to ask your questions now. Please wait for the microphone so all of your fans, like all of the Ohms fans across the NBA, can hear and know who you are on NBA TV. So if you have a question, please raise your hand, and we will get the microphone to you. The young lady right there. Lance, would you please take care of that? Please state your name and where you're from.
Bridget Wentworth, Star Ledger. Bruce, my question is for you. Do you think that a move like this helps fans who might have been upset with what happened with Kenyon Martin sort of think, okay, now we are going in the right direction and you are making moves to make this team, you know, competitive?
It helps tremendously. We've had tremendous ticket sales since we've announced Vince Carter's coming to the team. So it makes a tremendous difference for fans, yes, tremendous.
Follow-up question.
Was it important to you, though, to be, you know, behind it, to be the person, you know, that you can say, you know, we brought this guy here, we are focused on doing that for fans?
What I want to emphasize, this is always about team. This is always about team. So it's not me, it's not Rod, it's not Vince. It's all of us working together. And I've said our management style is to work together in every kind of way. Coach, same thing. And so it's not about Bruce Ratner or any particular individual. It's about working together, and we do it very well.
Ohm.
New York Daily News. This question is for Bruce. Bruce, are you hoping that this move by getting a player of Vince's caliber will make Jason Kidd change his mind and want to stay as a Net?
Well, I'm going to let Rod answer a specific question about, you know, Jason, but you know, Jason's very excited about this. It's an incredible triumvirate, really, the three players and the rest of the team, of course, just excellent. So, three are going to work together. Rod, you want to say anything?
As you know, Ohm, from your conversations with Jason, Jason is very happy to have Vince coming here. Jason and Vince teamed up in 2000. They teamed up again in Puerto Rico. They've been in various all-star games, and they've always worked very well together. And I think Vince's talent, you know, if you look what Jason does, Jason is a facilitator above all, and Vince is a finisher above all. And those two guys are very simpatico in the way they play and in how they can play off each other. So, and then when you add Richard to that mix, you know, it makes for a very, very exciting triumvirate on the floor.
Back over here, please.
Al Cochran, Bronx Times. Questions for Vince Carter. Vince, I was wondering when you first heard about the trade and you were coming to play here with Jason Kidd and Richard Jefferson, you know, sort of your style of play there. What was your feelings about it, and how excited were you to come play with this fast-paced team?
Well, when I first heard about it, I was actually asleep in bed, and my family would call me and said, hey, you just got traded. And I thought it was a joke a little bit because, you know, like I told them, I never really knew New Jersey was in the picture. And, you know, all of a sudden I was like, okay. And the first thing I could think of was, you know, me playing with Jason Kidd in 2000 and the success we had. And then the three of us, RJ and Jay Kidd and myself playing in Puerto Rico. And not only the fun we had, but just how easy it was for us to score and create for each other as well as the other two guys on the floor. So I was excited about that. It definitely plays in to my style of play. And like I said, I'm just going to step in and just do what I can do, but yet do it within the team off what Coach Frank asked.
Right there, Lance, right there. Bob.
Thanks. Bob Considine, Gannett. Bruce, how curious are you to see if the addition of Vince is going to help you bring some New Jersey fans to Brooklyn, and also for Vince, the idea of playing in Brooklyn maybe someday? What do you think about that?
Well, I know already it's a successful fan experience that's going to be seen. In other words, I think it's clear that fans are very excited by the new Nets. It's clear that ticket sales are showing that. Also, anecdotally, people come up to me and say, this is a great, great thing. I think there's been universal acceptance to how wonderful it is to have Vince as an addition to the team.
And for me, I just think, you know, our play will take care of itself. We go out there and give them something to cheer about, something to come watch night in and night out. The effort, just, of course, highlights. Everybody wants to see highlights. And, you know, you win games, it take care of a lot of things. And that definitely will take care of ticket sales. And as the transfer happens to Brooklyn, I think that the majority will follow, and plus what's going to already be there just because of the new atmosphere and the new era.
John.
John Delapina, Daily News. Bruce, I know you said it's not about you, but you did mention anecdotally. The last couple of weeks, have fans been, you know, all over you? And New York fans don't keep things to themselves.
No,
and has that totally changed since this?
There is a different attitude, I will say. And, of course, I'm happy about that. But I always said, you know, I really knew that we were going to be at this point because that was always the intention. Rod knows that. Our intention is to have a competitive team that wins. So I always knew we'd be here. It's just a question of whether it be today or a week from now or 2 weeks from now, whatever. I knew we'd be there.
David.
David Fox, Trentonian. Vince, how is your ankle feeling? If you had to go out tonight, what percentage effectiveness could you be?
Feels good. It feels good. They put me through a workout not too long ago. That's why I was late today, or running late. And I'm able to get up and down the floor and move well. And, you know, it's all about letting it all heal 100%. Because, like Rod said, my plan is to be here a long time and have a great career here and just win a lot of games. So you might as well take care of your business now, make sure it's healthy, and just go from there. But I feel great.
Fooch?
Vince, you could just talk about how unhappy maybe you might have been in Toronto and maybe how much that affected your game and how it could affect your game here if you are now happy playing with the New Jersey Nets.
I'm definitely happy. I feel like I'm glowing, so this is a great opportunity. I'm not here to badmouth Toronto or anything because it's a great city, and they've provided great things and a wonderful opportunity for me. You know, they drafted me, gave me the opportunity to be an NBA player. And, you know, now I just get a chance to move on. Like I say, just another phase of my life. And I have no hard feelings for anybody there. I appreciate what everything they've done for me. But it's just time to just move on and start over. We've all, you know, we had rough times. We have good times and bad times, just like anybody. And, you know, here I am now.
Mr. Elkin?
Robert Elkin, New York Voice. When is your target date when you might suit up and go on the floor?
We're hoping after Christmas, the 27th at Detroit is what we're looking for.
Lance, right here. Mr. Sheridan has a question.
Hi, Vince. Chris Sheridan from AP. It's been said about you that the Vince Carter we saw in 2000 at the Olympics was Vince Carter at his peak. And the drop-off in your numbers over the last 4 years is evidence that the Vince Carter we saw maybe in 98, 2000, 2001 is as good of a Vince Carter as we're ever going to see. How do you respond to that?
I still have room to grow. Every player in this league, as good as we may claim them to be, there, everybody has room to grow and get better, and that's my goal. Playing with a point guard like Jason, playing with a guy like RJ on the wing, it's just, I think, we can complement each other to raise our game to another level. And I definitely have been plagued by injuries, and I feel good. And I feel I'm rejuvenated. And this is an opportunity for me to just start over. I feel like a rookie again and just go out there and play hard and just get back to where I've been.
Any other questions? My friend from TSN.
Same. Hello, Vince. Same thing. Vince, have you spent any time envisioning what that feeling's going to be like putting on the jersey, getting out on the court, especially here at home in front of fans who probably will give you a little bit more respect than what you were getting back in Toronto?
I have, but it's nothing like actually living it, going through it, and letting it happen. I'm just going to stay focused and really just do my job. And that's all I can just think about, just being on the wing. Like I say, I got the opportunity to sit on the bench and watch the game in Charlotte, and I try to envision myself out there, but yet at the same time try to learn the plays as well. So it's a little tough learning on the fly. But as I get comfortable, that vision becomes a reality. So the vision I have now, I hope is becomes above and beyond, better than what I've been thinking when I actually get out there.
Okay. Bridget, one more question, please.
Thanks, Bridget Wentworth, Star Ledger. Rod, this question's for you. Just wondering if are there any other issues you would like to address through trades, and is size maybe one of the things you're thinking of, or, you know, is that on the back burner now at all?
Well, we are, you know, we're going to continue to try to get better. You know, obviously this is a big part of it, but you know, that's my job, Ed Stefanski's job. Every day we're talking with teams in the league, and we're going to try to, you know, to add pieces that will continue to make us better.